In this video, we are going to explain creating a different kind of geometry, that is mesh command. Using mesh, you can create geometries which cannot be made with simple solid or surface in tools. And there are some kinds of solids or geometries which can't even be made, and those kind of impossible geometries are made with the help of mesh tool. For accessing all mesh tools, go to this mesh tab. Here you will find all the components or tools related to mesh command. So I will start creating very simple mesh using this mesh box. So for that, I will switch to our 3D mesh space by clicking this home icon. Let's go click this primitive icon drop down and select box. Now specify first point, second point and third point. Here in the first look, you will find that it is very similar to the solid primitive which we have drawn in previous lessons, but when you hover your cursor over the geometry, you will see there are many faces and the geometry is clearly split into many parts. Now this is the difference between a mesh and normal solid. Mesh has got parts or faces depending upon the sections you design while creating the mesh. Now when you select this object, the complete geometry will be selected. So in order to choose the selected parts of this mesh, for example, in this case we have face here, we also have these vertices, and we have these edges. So these are different parts that can be chosen using the selected filter over here. Click this flyout and you will find the list tools. For example, let's say you want to select face, then choose face tool from this flyout. Then move your cursor to the face you want to select, and now only that particular face will be selected. In similar way, you can also choose other tools like this edge. Now only edge will be selected, not face. And if you want to show vertices in this geometry, then select it from the list. Then choose the vertex you want. So in this way, you will be able to select different filter and apply them in different parts of the geometry. These filters not only be used from this selection flyout, but also you can use it from this status bar. So here in the status bar, when you move your cursor to this point, you will notice that you have this selection option, and here you have vertex chosen. However, you can change to edge or face from here. Right now, I have selected face and click the face you want. Now this option of sub-object selection may not appear on the status bar. So in order to bring your status bar, click this optimization button, then mark this selection filtering. After that, it will be available on your status bar. Now, although by default the face has been divided into three sections, X, Y and Z axis, so when I select some complete geometry with no filter selected, you can see that in X axis we have these three faces, Y, 3 and 3 for the Z axis. But if you want to modify or change the number of faces, for that you need to click this small arrow in primitive panel. Now here you will see that length we have 3, width we have 3 and height 3. We can directly change from here. Right now box is selected, so the change will be applied to the box primitive. Here I'm giving 6 boxes length and width 6 and also height. Let's give 4 box or divisions and click OK. Now let's create one more mesh, and this time we will have more divisions in the mesh. Click it. As you can see, in the length we have 6 sections and the height we have four sections. When you compare with the old geometry, you will be able to see the difference clearly. So this was all about mesh and its components in AutoCAD.